Straight to the papers now,
yeah.
Austin.
Yes, Olawale Shola, sports analyst, is in the house.
That's right, that's right. Good to have you around.
Yeah, what's going on in the papers?
Thank you, Austin. Thank you, everybody. Good morning, everybody.
Yeah, and obviously you want to say a lot about the Chan situation as well.
Well, okay. I'm not surprised about our exit. I'll tell the truth. Because Coach Sunday Olise, since he has been appointed, I've been one of the critics. you don't brand the UEFA Pro license just for nothing. We need to see results on the pitch of play. Mm. Now, apart from the results, we need to see tactical improvement from our movements to positioning. Mm. That has not reflected in the national team.
Okay,
we complain about Keshi, we complain about Guavan, we complain about Siasia. Mm. Olise has continued with that trend of having flat performance.
Wow.
Against,
flat? Yes,
African
flat.
Guardiola?
Yes.
No, it's not flat. It's up and down. I mean, some very fantastic performance.
Yeah, let him
now, take for example now. We won Nigeria.
Yes.
Against Tunisia, we're lucky.
Against Nigeria?
Yeah, against Tunisia. Okay. After Nigeria,
we're
lucky.
We got lucky, yes.
To have a draw. Mm-hmm. Against Mali, we lost. That's a downtrend. It shows that the Nigerian match was a fluke. Was a total fluke. Because I had expected I would have improved if you have a good team. That's what you start your season.
So
what
if
you
the team was good, you would have expected
better performance against
Tunisia.
Tunisia.
Even if you play a draw against Guinea, you should be able to play for a draw.
You pick a result. But by the time you won your first game 4-1, your second game 1-1, your third game you lost. That's to me, you can count the first game a fluke.
Okay, and but the coach has come out to say the players were running on empty, you know, in the final game against Guinea. And we know it's well documented the money issues that they're having. But should that really be a motivating factor for professional footballers? You know, when you're playing a competition as big as the Chan tournament.
That is an excuse for lack of technical ability and quality.
Okay.
During the days of Rashidi Yekini, we went to Congo on empty stomach. Mm-hmm. Rashidi Yekini gave us an 8-minute call. That's when we had quality. When we played Burkina Faso in Lagos here, we didn't have jerseys. You had to cut tracks to make jerseys for them. We won 7-1.
What year was that?
This is
2016, brother.
Yeah, when you have quality, you get results.
That's right.
And you stop giving excuses.
Yeah.
What you're saying is you don't have quality in the Nigerian team, right?
Yes.
There's no quality.
Yes.
Okay, straight to the papers. Sporting Life here. We'll start with this one. Chan's disgraceful outing. NFF queries Olise. Coach to get notice in Abuja, but the coach is not coming. Glasser's Chiefs insist on submission of technical reports. Then board members miffed over tacticians' talk of moral issues. That's coming from Sporting Life. What do you think about this?
Hmm. Okay, just to start with, we are coming back to Nigeria. The coach is not coming with us.
Yeah, but they're going to pay him.
Now, they'll pay him. Now, if it's a foreign coach, fine, that would have been tenable. Hmm. Only say it's a Nigerian. Our performance has shown that Olise don't watch the Nigerian league enough.
Hmm.
There are some players that don't have business in Chan.
Hmm.
But when you don't watch the league, there are so many. Are you telling me that you don't have a good attacking midfielder that can hold the ball, that can determine the game for us?
But we saw that in the first game.
Ogunigare at table.
We saw that against Niger.
Well, Niger are the whipping boys of the group.
They are the whipping boys. They lost 5-0 to Tunisia. So our result was not a big deal.
And it was nervy. It was nervy in the first
game. The second one is a fallout of Eagles ouster from Chan. And this one is Senate committee to okay Olise's sack if NFF decides.
Yeah. That's
well,
a decision.
I wouldn't like that. Okay. Because I wouldn't like government interference in our football.
Okay.
I don't think that we'll have grown to a level where our technical decision is respected. We don't have this kind of a situation. The Senate should not put mouth in our football.
Okay.
Our football should, the sole responsibility of the daily activities of our football should rest with the NFF. Mm. I'm against that.
Okay, Olawale, it's getting out in here with this talk on Sunday, Olise, and the Chan Eagles. Let's go over to the Complete Sports newspaper now. I'll read what they have on the front page. Dejected Eagles return home today to get bonuses, allowances next week. I pray they get it. And then, but let's not talk about that. Let's come to some West Ham agreed loan deal for Emmanuel Emenike. I think that's a good one for his career.
It's a very good one because his career has gone on the downward spiral from leaving Fenerbahce to Al Ahly You know, the Eremites, at least they did the first for him. Mm. And I hope he gets to the Premiership and perform.
That's right.
Yeah, hopefully, yeah, that'll be very key.
Sports Day,
the big one is still about Emenike joining West Ham. Deal agreed already, it's a loan move. He has got to pass his medicals and as well, you know, get a work permit. So hopefully all that, you know, works very well.
But one thing, if you got to get a shirt in them.
Yeah,
quality player.
Yeah, it's all about, you know, bringing a body into the team. See. You know, that's what depth, we always talk about it every time, and it's very important. And
that's right.
He'll be an extra.
Billy signed him just as a backup.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. As the season gets hotter, you need some players to bring in.
Exactly.
Because of his experience.
Exactly.
He has played in the World Cup. He has been on fire for Fenerbahce for years before he had a gold trot. So it's good for West Ham. It's good for him too. It's a win-win situation.
Absolutely. Yeah. United renew Guardiola on. Like, they're not giving up.
They should have.
Even though it looks and all in the indications point to the fact that he's going to Man City. But why would Guardiola pick a Manchester United over a Manchester City? Let's look at it very objectively.
The history.
It's simple. Pedigree.
Okay.
History.
Okay.
Glamour. Glory.
Absolutely. Mm.
Ferguson days, for 20 years, they were there.
Okay.
Premiership, the Champions League, he wants two Champions League titles. So they are going to a drought now. They need someone that will bring that colour. Yeah. You know, there are some clubs that if you get to a level, you have colour. Mm-hmm. Barcelona, Bayern Munich, Juve, AC Milan, that's a tradition.
Okay.
Tradition of beautiful football. When you play beautiful football, you get the top players. When you get the top players, you get sponsorship, you get the money.
If you're not careful,
they will lose that glamour, they will lose that respect, they will lose that pedigree.
Good point.
So they need someone to get them in the first place.
Yeah, good point by Olawale. But yeah. I like to say Guardiola in his very short career has managed only the best teams in the world. Barca, crack squad. Mm. Bayern, crack squad. Manchester United, I don't think would... No, I didn't say that, Cecilia, but you get my point. but you get my point. So why... Just in terms of the playing personnel,
okay.
I don't see any reason why he would leave a team that's got Aguero, Silva, Torre, and all those informed players and go for a team that's got, you know, those other players there as well. You get my point? You get my point. They're not playing really well this season.
Bastian is Rooney.
Thank you.
Yeah. Like, are you having a laugh now?
Is it the girl?
Yeah, he's having a laugh, but you get my point. Yeah, in terms of the team, playing personnel alone, Manchester City right now, they're on the right track. United, they're derailing.
You know, this is a challenge for you.
Exactly.
But you think he's going to take it?
Don't take one thing away from him.
He has never
when
had
he was
challenge.
Appointed in Barcelona, Barcelona, the previous season, they were leading 11 points against Real Madrid.
Mm.
They fulfilled it because of Eto and Ronaldinho's scuffle. Now, it gave Barcelona one thing. It gave them a style of play that we've never seen since the days of Juan Carlos when Juan Carlos coached Barcelona. The tiki-taka. You know, let me tell something. Guardiola is a man of God. When he was appointed as Barcelona's coach, Eto'o, Rolandinho, Deco, they were the one controlling it. He said, he doesn't need these players, he needs new players.
Right.
We now saw the best of Sergio Busquets, Andres Iniesta, Xavi, even Messi.
So it means he can put top players to Manchester United.
He's a master tactician.
He can take all the good players in Bayern Munich.
There are some players
that will not go to some clubs because of the type of coach you have there.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely, yes. Okay. Absolutely, but the point is, the Barcelona team, it took over, not as bad in any shape or form as this Manchester United.
Okay. Let me just go back to Sporting. Final paper here today now. Is this one that says Ramirez complete move to China. And also you have Gervinho also going to China. And is that the new Super Rich League?
It's not new for Ana.
No, I'm looking at the age. Drogba went there at a certain age.
The twilight of his
career. I'm looking at Ramirez. He has so much to offer Chelsea.
They just signed a 4-year deal.
Exactly. Gervinho is just 28. I mean, he was doing well with AS Roma, and he's there also. I'm wondering...
Ramirez can't play for...
That one is telling you now. Money called the shots in the level of footballers nowadays.
Ramirez can play in that Arsenal midfield. Ramirez can play in that Tottenham midfield.
Even Manchester United, that, like, hey,
the passion
they don't even have someone who can run.
And among players, you can't find it anymore now.
Okay,
people passion. Are looking for money all around.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you're passionate... You don't go to China at this age and time of your career.
Ramirez, that's
shocking. Ramirez still have a lot to offer.
Gervinho,
I'm expected.
Gervinho from Arsenal to Roma and
Sporting son, Osimhen rejects Anderlecht. All right, go on. What do you think about that story? Asim Victor Osimhen.
Oh, I bet he has signed for Wolfsburg.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I know. Signing for Wolfsburg is good. Or they're a team that have a good model. And the Bundesliga, you have a good model of producing young players.
That's right.
Okay. Of turning the careers of young players to take them to stardom. But Anderlecht has been a very good club for Nigerian players.
That's right.
But I know the agents, although the people around me, but must have had a lot of influence on him signing for Wolfsburg.
Wolfsburg, okay. Definitely. I wish him well, and of course, he gets to play regularly. That is what is important. There are players that just love Pato who will say, okay, let me find a home in the Premier League, going to Chelsea at 26. That's good. Not going to China or Alain.
Okay, still, this year, the English Capital One Cup, it's going to be Manchester City versus Liverpool. That one should get us talking. But what a game. What Everton a versus Manchester United last night. And what a match.
Manchester City.
Manchester City.
Yeah. Oh, and once again, Everton, you know, can't defend to save their lives. You know, you go ahead, a goal. Hope you expected to defend it, you know, for a bit, but they end up conceding an equalizer almost straight away, 6 minutes after.
That hasn't been this season.
Let me ask that question. How good is John Stone? Well, it's not as good as Chelsea was thinking.
To me, he's young.
He's a decent player.
He's young, he's a decent player. Yeah. He still has room for improvement.
You need a compliment
of other good players.
But the problem is that the hype that surrounds English players make you wonder all the time. You understand?
Because Everton
defense was in total in shambles, and that has been the bane this season. If John Stones is part of that defense, and that defense has been the problem, I don't see the noise and the ulubalu that surrounds him signing for Chelsea.
So why do they have to let Naismith leave?
They have a plethora of attacking players.
Naismith
is going young. They have Delafoe.
Yeah.
Lukaku.
Yes.
They have Ross Barkley. These are younger players. David Morales. These are younger players. And it's good for Norwich, it's good for his own career too.
That's right.
It is a place where he can cement a regular place. He has never cemented a regular place with Everton.
Nope.
He has been off and on.
Okay.
And so anyways, Jurgen Klopp says he's going to win the final. And Manuel Pellegrini says he's going to win the final as well. So I wonder who's going to win. Surely the two of them can win at the same time.
You know what
I'm looking forward to a cracker.
Let the best team win.
What I know is that we got to go.
Yeah, that one is very certain, right? Okay,
thank you so much, Shola, for coming to the program.
Thank you,
Shola. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Cecilia Omogbe. Of course, tomorrow we'll be here for another program.
Yeah, surely. Thanks for watching and join us tomorrow, like Sissy said, for another exciting package. I'm Tahir Salam.
But you know, we won't leave without letting you know that you can keep talking to us on Twitter, with channels_sports, and on Facebook, with channels_sports. That's the show. I'm Austin Okunatman, and everything you do, remember, let's keep talking sports. Bye for now.